Welcome students, today we are going to talk about lab number 9. The title of this lab is to show the response of an encoder decoder and to reproduce the binary converters using basic logic gates. First, discuss the objectives of this lab. The first objective is to explain the basic functionality and working of encoder using logic gates. Second, to explain the basic functionality and working of decoder using logic gates. Third, to display the results of various application of encoder using hardware and software platform. Fourth, to display the results of various application of decoder using hardware and software platform. What is a decoder? A decoder is a combinational circuit that connects the binary information from n input lines to a maximum of 2 raised to power n output lines, which means if we have n number of inputs, we will have 2 raised to power n outputs. For example, if we say we have 2 inputs, then we will have 4 outputs, as 2 raised to power 2 is equal to 4. A decoder is also known as a minterm generator or a maxterm generator. Minterm generator is constructed using the AND and NOT gates. The appropriate output is indicated by logic bind. The minterm generator works on the positive logic, whereas if we consider the maxterm generator, it is constructed by using the NAND gates. The output is indicated by the logic 0. It works on the negative logic. We are going to use IC74139 for decoding. The part 2 of this lab, you are going to use a 7-segment display. A 7-segment display is a form of electronic display which is used for displaying the decibel numbers. 7-segment displays are most widely used in digital clock, electronic meters, basic calculators and other electronic devices which display the information. 0 to 9 are the most commonly used numbers on 7-segment displays. We can also display the hexadecimal numbers on the 7 segment. In this lab, you are going to use 7447 IC for the 7 segment. Here you can see this is the internal structure of the 7 segment display. It has 8 LEDs and a dot LED as well. There are two types of 7 segment display configuration that are mostly used. One is common cathode configuration and another is common anode configuration. In common cathode configuration, all the cathodes of LEDs are connected together. In order to make this display work, the common pin has to be connected with ground and you have to power the other pin with VCC. You can see here all the cathodes are connected together here and these are connected with ground. You have to apply the VCC at these pins to make this 7 segment display work. In the common anode configuration, all the anodes of the LEDs are connected together and they are connected with VCC for its working, while the cathode side you have to connect it with ground for the working of common anode 7 segment display. In the part 3 of this lab, you are going to use a BCD encoder. An encoder performs a function that is opposite of decoder. It has maximum 2 raised to power n input line and n output line. It will produce a binary code equivalent to that of input, which is mostly active high. One of the advantages of encoding data is that it reduces the number of lines required to represent the data. For example, if a memory has 16 different locations, in order to access these 16 locations, you need to have 16 lines or bits to access this data. So, by using encoder, you can reduce these 16 lines or addresses to only 4 lines only. Such reduction improves the speed of information processing in digital system. You are going to use IC74447 for the encoding purpose. Let's see the lab task part 1. In the first lab task, you have to implement a 2 to 4 line decoder using a maxterm generator. This is the truth table of 2 to 4 line decoder using a maxterm generator. So when the input is 0, 0, the least significant bit will be high, which is Y0, as it is working on a positive logic, so the output is indicated by 1. When the input is 0, 1, the second output will be high. Similarly, on 1, 0, third output will be high, and on 1, 1, Y3 will be high, which is the most significant bit. You can derive these equations using this table. You can see here for the Y0, we can write AB complement as A is 0 and B is 0. For Y1, A is 0 and B is 1, so we can write it as A bar B, and similarly these two equations you can derive. This is the circuit of a 2 to 4 line decoder. This is a Minterm generator decoder. So this circuit is implemented using NOT and gates only using these equations. If you want to use a maxterm generator, the output is indicated by logic 0. You can see here when the input is 0, 0, the Y naught is 0. Here 0 is representing the logic high as it is a maxterm generator. Similarly on 0, 1, Y1 is 0 and so on it continues. You can derive this equation and implement this circuit using the NAND gates only. In the part 2 of this lab, you are going to use a 7 segment decoder IC. The IC that you are going to use is 7447. It is a 16 pin IC which is used for displaying the BCD numbers on 7 segment display. Here you can see pin number 7, 1, 2 and 6 are the inputs of this IC, while pin number 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 15 and 14 are the outputs. This IC basically works on the active low logic, which means when the output here will be 0, it will act as a high output for the 7 segment display. Here there are three other pins which are 3, 4 and 5. These pins are also working on active low logic, which means you have to apply 0 or ground here to avail the purpose of this pin. Here LT means lamp test. Basically this lamp test is basically used to test the 7 segment display whether all the LEDs are working properly or not in that 7 segment. So when you apply 0 here, all the LEDs of the 7 segment display will glow. If any of the LED here is not glowing, it means our 7 segment display is faulty. So if all the LEDs are glowing, it means our 7 segment display is working fine. Here RBO and RBI pins are used when you want to connect multiple 7 segment displays. Here currently we are using only one 7 segment display, so these pins are not required. Now let's move on to our 7 segment display. Here you can see that pin number 3 and 8 are common pins of the 7 segment display, as this pin is connected with the VCD which is 5 volt. So this means that our 7 segment display has common anode configuration. If you see the truth table of the 7 segment decoder IC, here you can see when you apply 0000 at the input, the output here only G will be equal to 1, while A, B, C, D, E, F will be equal to 0 as it is working on active low logic. So here 0 is considered as high while 1 is considered as 0 for this decoder IC. But it actually means here G LED will be off while A, B, C, D, E, F will be on. So it will display 0 at the output on the 7 segment display. Similarly, if you see here, if you apply 1001, here D and E will be equal to 1 while A, B, C, F, G will be equal to 0. What it actually means, if you see here, if D and E equal to 1, D and E, the number appear will be equal to 9. In lab task number part 3, you are going to implement 3 circuits: decimal to BCD encoder, octal to binary converter and hexadecimal to binary encoder. In this lab task, you are going to implement decimal to BCD encoder. The IC that we are going to use is 74147. It is a 10 to 4 line priority encoder IC. You have already studied the priority encoder in your theory. For detailed overview, you can consult those lectures. As we are converting the decimal number to BCD, so it has 10 input lines and 4 output lines. These input and output lines are working on active low logic, which means 0 will be considered as high output. You have to connect the pin number 16 to VCC, pin number 8 to ground, and you don't need to connect pin number 15 with any wire. If you see the truth table here, as you know that IC is working on inverted logic, which is active low inputs and active low outputs. So when you apply here 1, here 0 is representing high and one is representing low. So when you've applied one here, the output will be equal to 1, 1, 1 and 0, which is equal to 1, as this IC is working on inverted logic. Similarly, if you move here, this equivalent, this number is equivalent to 8, so the output here will be equal to 0, 1, 1. So you have to fill this table accordingly, no matter what will be the conditions here, as this is working on priority encoder logic, so output will be equal to 0, 1, 1 here. In the next part of this lab, you have to implement an octal to binary converter. The IC that you are going to use is 74148. And this is a 8x3 line priority encoder IC, which has 8 active low inputs and 3 active low output. To enable this IC, you have to apply ground at the enable pin of this IC, as it is working on active low logic. Here there are two other pins that are being used, which is GS and E0. Basically these are gray outputs. You don't need to use this pin in your lab task. One thing that you need to take care of is that you have to connect the cathode terminal with these outputs, and you have to apply the positive voltage at the anode terminal, as this IC is working on the active low logic. I will share the circuit in the next slide, that how to connect this IC with the LEDs. As shown here in the circuit, that I have connected the VCC voltage with the anode terminal of the LED, and the cathode terminal of the LED is connected with the output of the IC. Same for these two LEDs. So when the output will be high, which will, as it is working on active low logic, so here a pair will be 0, and the LED will have 0 here, and it will get the voltage from here and the LED will glow. So when it will have high here, there will be same potential at both the ends of LED, so the LED won't glow. This is how this LED is working. Practically, when you are working on the breadboard, you have to connect 330 ohm resistor here to limit the voltage drop across the LED. In the next part of this lab, you have to implement a hexadecimal to binary encoder. Here in this circuit, you can see that we are using three ICs. Two ICs are of 8x3 encoder, and this is the first 8x3 encoder, and this is the second 8x3 encoder. The next IC that we are using is 74157. This is a quad 2x1 multiplexer. It has 4 2x1 multiplexer. The select pin is common for all the multiplexer. The output of the first encoder you can see here. Here we are getting the outputs of the first encoder, which is connected to the two multiplexers. And similarly, the output of the second encoder is connected to the next two multiplexer of 74157 IC. Here, one of the output of the second encoder is connected with the select pin. And you can see here, the enable pins are connected in such a way that for the first 7 input, the first encoder is on, and for the next inputs, the second encoder is on. You have to implement this circuit on the Proteus and verify your results. The 74157 IC is also working on active low logic for the outputs. So in order to glow the LEDs, you have to connect the cathode point of the LED with this point, and you have to apply the VCC at the anode point of the voltage, as discussed in the previous task. So implement this circuit on the Proteus and verify your results and fill the table accordingly. The post lab task, you have to design encoder and decoder using lab task number 1 and lab task number 3 using the NAND and NOR kits only. This is all for the lab. Thank you.